creating the future without making things worse would be a good thing. I've often commented that the problems that we face today are the direct result of yesterday's solutions. And the problems that we will face tomorrow are most likely the direct result of today's actions or inactions. So I thought I would sort of tinker and put together this set of relationships and unfold a set of thoughts. So if I start with the current situation, which is probably not what I want it to be, because I have a preference, I almost always have a preference for things being different than they are. So there's a gap between the desired situation and the current situation. That gap induces me to develop an understanding, a strategy, adopt that strategy in an attempt to move the current situation in the direction of the desired situation so that the situation gap becomes zero over time. And to the extent that I really understand all of the relationships that are relevant to this undertaking, I can develop a strategy and adoption that will get me there. Now, oftentimes, the understanding actually results in me increasing or making the desired situation greater, usually referred to as scope creep. So it will actually take longer to get to where I want to go. The other alternative is, at times, if it takes a long time to get to the desired situation, there's a pressure to settle for less so that it reduces the desired situation. This is the situation where I decide in January that I want to lose 20 pounds and I lose 10 pounds and I seem to have plateaued, so I decide that 10 pounds was enough. And I mean, the easiest way to reach the goal is to make the goal the current situation, and then you don't have to do anything. And when have we ever done that before? Now, the difficulty that we encounter in doing this is that the situations that we face today are extremely, at best, complex and usually perceived as being complicated. And our understanding of them is not nearly what it could be or should be. And the ongoing problem of cause and effect being separated in time and space so that more often than not, we don't actually sense the implications of our actions. As Senge said in the fifth discipline, you can never do just one thing. There are always multiple implications of any action that you take. So what happens as a result of doing this adoption is there are typically unintended consequences which actually end up making the current situation worse, or they actually create new problems that we or someone else has to figure out how to deal with after the fact. So we maybe move toward the current situation in the direction of the desired situation, though we have more problems to deal with than we started with. What we could or should do is to actually, part of our problem is once we think we have the answer, we tend to stop thinking. If we actually looked at the strategy and investigated the potential unintended consequences, which is relatively quite doable if one understands the nature of the frequently recurring structures that happen, and I talked about those in a previous musing, in that things tend to evolve in certain ways. So if I'm attempting to pursue a particular goal, fix a problem, it creates a problem elsewhere. Things get better and then worse, or addiction structures, or diminishing goals, or all of these things that are likely to happen. And if you investigate these possible alternatives, it's possible to actually head off some of these unintended consequences before they actually come up to bite us in the butt. The difficulty is we have structures in place where seldom, if ever, do we reward people for dissolving problems before they happen. If you really want to be rewarded, you have to create a problem and then solve it. So the intent is to understand that we create the future based upon our actions or inactions, and we could, in fact, get much better at doing this, and there are ways to go about that. Now, can you absolutely ensure that you avoid unintended consequences as a result of your actions? No, though you should put in place sensors that continue to monitor things that might change so that you get an indication of problems that are about to arise before they arise. Though, how often does that ever happen? So, just another set of thoughts to ponder, and I'll see you in another video soon. Bye.